This video is going to be about solving a quadratic equation by factoring. So let's look at an example and try to understand this. I've got the equation x squared minus 3x equals 18. And because the largest exponent is a 2, this is considered a quadratic equation. Now, when we say we want to solve it, what that means is we're looking for the value, or values, there may be more than one, we're looking for the values of x that will make this equation balance. Here's how we're going to do it. The first step is we want to get all the terms on one side of the equation and have the other side of the equation just equal 0. So if we subtract 18 from both sides, we'll be able to do that. I'm going to get x squared minus 3x minus 18 equals 0. When your equation looks like this, with a 0 on one side, that's considered the standard form of the quadratic equation. Okay, now looking at the left side, what you see is basically I've got a second degree polynomial. So we're going to factor that. We'll factor it down to two binomials, and the product of those two binomials will equal 0. So x squared minus 3x minus 18. That tells me I probably want an x here and here. Looking at the signs, I see that the sign for the third term is negative. So I'm looking for two factors of 18, one positive and one negative, that I can add together and get a negative 3. So let's see how we can factor 18. So 18 is 1 times 18, but the difference between 1 and 18 is 17, so that won't work. I can think of it as 2 times 9. But once again, the difference is not 3. I can factor 18 down as 3 and 6, and that will do it, because 3 from 6 is 3. So I'm going to have a 3 and a 6. And now I just have to figure out which one's positive and which one's negative. So the trick I use is, looking at the sign of the second term, which is negative, I give that sign to the larger of the two numbers. So I've got x plus 3 times x minus 6 equals 0. Now, at this point, what you have to realize is that if I've got two things, let's say these two binomials, and I multiply them together and they equal 0, then at least one of them has to equal 0. In other words, if x plus 3 equals 0, then 0 times x minus 6 is going to be 0. And if x minus 6 equals 0, then x plus 3 times 0 will give me 0. So what I'm going to do is make two equations out of this. I'm going to say that x plus 3 equals 0, and x minus 6 equals 0. And I'm going to solve the two equations. So these are pretty easy to solve. I just subtract 3 from both sides of this first one, and I'm going to get x equals 3. Solving the second one, I add 6 to both sides, and I get x equals negative 3, and x equals 6. So I think that my answers, my solutions, will be x equals negative 3 and 6. Now, let me just say a word about vocabulary here. These two numbers are called the solutions to the equation. But there are a number of different words that people use instead of solutions. Sometimes you'll hear people call them the roots of the equation. So if somebody says, find the roots of this equation, you're going to do the same thing. Sometimes they're called zeros. That also means the same thing. And if people are thinking of graphs, then they're going to call these the x-intercepts. So any of those terms could be applied to these two numbers. Now, we still have to check and make sure we're right. So let's rewrite the original problem. X squared minus 3x equals 18. And let's plug in negative 3 to see if this will work. So I would have negative 3 squared minus 3 times negative 3. Let's see if that equals 18. Okay, negative 3 times negative 3 is a positive 9. And once again, negative 3 times negative 3 is a positive 9. So 9 plus 9 is 18, so that's a correct answer. Let's plug in a 6, the other answer. 6 squared minus 3 times 6 equals 18. Let's see if that works. 6 times 6 is 36. 3 times 6 is 18, so it's minus 18 equals 18. 36 minus 18 does equal 18, so these answers check. Okay, reviewing this process. I take the original equation. I put it into standard form, which basically means manipulating it. So all of the terms are on one side of the equation, and I set that equal to 0 on the other side. And I'm going to write the exponents, the exponents, so that they're going into descending order. In other words, x squared, x to the first, and then just the constant. In other words, I'm setting it up like a standard second degree polynomial. Then I take that second degree polynomial and factor it. I then take each of the factors and say that factor equals 0. So in other words, I'm making two equations. I solve each equation, and the solutions to the equations should be the solutions to my original problem. The way to check it will be to take each of those solutions, or roots, or zeros, or x-intercepts, whatever you want to call them, take each of those and plug them back into the original equation. If the equation balances, then the answers are correct. Okay, there's a couple more details that I want to go over, but there's not going to be time in this video, so I'll continue with another one. See you soon.